Hey everybody, it's John at Freshwater Systems. In our ongoing series of answering frequently asked questions, today we're discussing home water test kits. Water comes out of the sink pretty clear, but what's in there? So we're going to discuss the various test types, the various processes that can enable you at home to do some of your own water testing. What is a home water test kit? Home water test kits are in a variety of methods, styles, and shapes. We go from simple test strips that you literally dunk in the water and swirl it around for a few minutes or seconds, and then compare the test strip colors to the colors possibly on the side of the bottle. We also have chemical titration type tests that works for hardness and iron. We have photometers, we have TDS electronic handheld meters that also can do things like pH or ORP, which is oxidation reduction potential. Just a variety of sizes and shapes so that you can do it at home. What do these test kits test for? They test for a variety of things. We can go through a lot of inorganics like iron, like hardness, total dissolved solids. We can get into specifics like lead, like nitrates. We can look for arsenic. When it comes to bacteria testing, we're fairly limited with these types of tests to look just for coliform. And the reason coliform is important is because it's an indicator bacteria. And it can give you the idea that there could be something more specific or more dangerous or harmful, specifically E. coli. One of the tests, the bacteria tests that we sell, if it shows positive for coliform with a little handheld UV light, you can further test and see if E. coli is present. There's just a litany of different test capabilities in some of the photos meters. You can get into cyanides, you can get into copper, you can get into lead and just a variety of things. But there are some things that we're not quite able to do, like cryptosporidium. That would not be something that we could use a home test kit for. What are the options for water testing? Well, there's a variety of options. There's a variety of methods. But a lot of it is fairly specific to what it is we want to find out. For example, if you want to make sure that your water softener is working, a water hardness test strip would be ideal. You're just going to dip it in the water periodically. Oh, looks like it's working. If you're concerned about contaminants like nitrates or arsenic, then that's going to require a little more specific type testing. For example, an arsenic kit is several phases of taking a sample of water, putting some different compounds in it, to create a gas in the sample bottle, which then interacts with a test strip. Another example would be a bacteria or a coliform test that you're going to put the sample of water in the bottle and then you're going to let it sit for 48 hours to see if it changes color. And based upon the color of water, it's giving you a presence or an absence of coliform bacteria. There's other meters, handheld type meters like this, that you can put in the water supply, and it's going to give you an immediate test result. This is a TDS meter. It's looking at dissolved solids through a process called conductivity, a little electric current between the two probes. And this one also gives you temperature. There's also meters for pH. There's meters for ORP, which is oxidation reduction potential. For those that really like high alkaline type systems, that's a good number to know. So there's just a wide variety of test kits, and it's fairly specific to what it is you're trying to figure out. How do water test strips work? Well, a lot of that depends upon what it is we're trying to find. For example, if we're looking for nitrates, well, we can do a test strip type test for that. If we're looking for bacteria, specifically coliform, well, we're going to need to capture some water and we're going to let it sit for 48 hours to see if it turns the color of the solution. If we're looking for hardness, we can use a test strip or we can use a titration type chemical drop method to get to how much hardness is in the water. And in a lot of cases, test strips have a variety or an average range that might be 3 to 5 or might be 100 to 500 depending upon the contaminant, whereas typically chemical type tests are going to be a little bit more accurate and give you a specific number. Photometers use test strips in the process, but because the photometer is comparing colors, those tests are going to be very specific and very accurate. Do home water test kits test for hardness? Yes, they do. We offer a couple of different types of hardness tests. One would be with a test strip. It's going to give you a range. It's going to let you know whether you're getting soft water or not. Or if you want to test your city water, it's going to tell you kind of from a range of hardness. A titration type where we're dropping chemicals into a test bottle, that's going to be a lot more accurate in terms of how many grains per gallon that you have. So if you're setting equipment or you're maintaining equipment, want to make sure you've got it set up properly, we'd recommend that you use the titration type, the chemical type, to get that accuracy so you can set your equipment up properly. Are test kits reliable? Are they accurate? Well, the answer to that is yes or no. The bottom line is to make sure that your test sample bottle is clean. It doesn't have anything in there that could sway the test. You want to make sure for a test strip that it is not past the expiration date. That's pretty important because when they go past expiration, you really can't trust the accuracy. When you're using chemicals to do a titration or any kind of other mixture, you got to make sure that the chemicals are also not expired. You got to make sure that your sample is not contaminated. So with basic common sense and following the instructions to the T, and they're not expired, you can pretty much rely on the test results from any of these kits. Where can I buy one of these home test kits? Well, I got to tell you, freshwatersystems.com is probably the best place to get your testing equipment, test strips, or products. So home test kits are really great handy tools for you to keep up on your water quality, to keep up on whether or not your water treatment equipment is working properly. And it's kind of important also for your own state of mind that you have the ability at whenever you want to, is to get one of these test kits and test your water. And then you know what's in that nice clear glass is not going to harm you. Well, that's all we have for test strips. Be sure and like this video, subscribe to our channel, and check us out on our website, freshwatersystems.com.